that I got from there, which is life is short, ask yourself why. Take the risk, afford. You can afford to learn, treat every day as a learning process. I think you guys will agree with me, the six gentlemen in front of you have shared a lot of very, very good experience, good and bad. And I think they deserve another round of humongous applause. I'm sure there's some questions that's burning. Or did you guys want to go and eat? What you guys want to do? Makan or ask some questions? Makan? Makan, you want to ask questions? Life is too short, you want to makan? So, I think if you take 10, Chris, you take 10, 15 minutes, that will maybe serve a couple of questions.
Can you eat later?
Yes.
That? There you go. So, crowd has spoken. First question, guys, direct to whoever you want specifically or to all, that's fine. Joanne, the crowd has spoken, they don't want to eat. Yeah. Don't want to eat yet. She gave the go ahead. So, first question.
Yeah.
Yes, you want to mosey on along to the mic before I get Chris to mosey you to the mic.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Jason. I'm from DCSP. I have one question for Dr. Ricky.
Dr. Ricky.
Okay, good afternoon, gentlemen. Dr. Ricky, my question is, you know, they say, okay, that academic qualifications do not determine an entrepreneur.
That's
I believe Aidan and Henry would agree with that. That's right. But when I heard that you have a first-class honors from Lancaster in accounting and finance, I'm also a graduate, and I hold a degree. I'd like to know from you, what did that first-class honors actually mean for you?
I discovered this, you see. There's a lot of dropouts are doing very well. So actually, I forgo my master. I continue to do business because I thought that I'm wasting my time doing the studies. Most of the knowledge that I gained in the books maybe a little bit can apply in the real world. But I discovered this study is not about the knowledge. Study is about making friends, making networks. So as I said in my slides, professional network people. So friends that you meet during your school days may help you during your career. It saves you very number of years that are hard work. So there's an old saying that it's not about what you know, it's who you know in business. I think this is the different version that I've gone through, that the dropouts that have been very successful and have a head start among those who have selected a path, go through a degree, master or even PhD. But the outcome is maybe the same or maybe different. It's what drives you, what is your mission. I think this is for me.
Thank you very much. That answers my question.
Next question, please. Tell you what, why don't we try that for five? No, 5 questions, nobody goes on the market. So we got 4 to go. Thanks. Wow,
Hi, my name is Ahmed, and I'm directing my question to Mr. Kai Lee. From my understanding, you said that you need to ride on the big waves of change in order to succeed. And I understand that that means the popular trends that are occurring throughout the world or perhaps in the local area. My question is, how do you figure out what the big waves are? And do you need to have contacts in order to be able to do that? Or are you able to analyze it yourself personally just by surfing through the internet? Thank you.
That's a good question. There's two ways I would look at it. Like on one hand, I would say that I wouldn't want to start a business on a wave that's not there. You know, a wave that isn't ready to hit yet, you know? Like some things are really, if you look at, for example, this Gartner's research from Gartner, this Gartner hype cycle,